Good morning students, welcome back. In this period we are going to learn the new point, conversion of decimal numbers into rational number. Okay, so in previous section we have seen that the conversion of or the rational number can be either represented as terminating decimal or non-terminating repeating decimals, right? So in this section we will learn about the exactly reverse of that. Means what? We have to convert the decimal number into the rational number, right? Before we have learned the rational number converted to decimal number. Now we have here decimal numbers, then we have to convert into the rational number. So there are the two types of these decimal number. Some are the terminating decimals and some are which type of numbers, means another type is non-terminating repeating decimal. Then how to convert into the rational form. Okay, so rational form means everyone knows that rational form means which type of form? Yes, of course, rational form means P by Q form, correct? Now here we have to convert this decimal number into which form? P by Q form. So here first we will see a decimal number is of the terminating nature. Okay, means there are the two types of numbers, or there are the two natures are of this type of numbers. Decimal numbers is of the terminating nature and another decimal numbers is of which type of nature? Non-terminating repetitive, correct? So here first we will see the express the following numbers into which form? P by Q form, means which form? Rational number form. Okay, so here if you will see, for examples I have written here 0.5, 0.25, 0.675 and here 0.00026. So from these numbers simply we can understand that this type of numbers, this terminating or non-terminating, yes, this is terminating decimal expansion. Means whatever the rational form of these numbers, that is which type of expansion it is there? Terminating decimal expansion. Because after carrying such a division, so after decimal point one place you will carry the division will stop, means you will get the remainder zero. The same here after two places, means when you will carry the division after decimal point, then how many places? Two places, then you will get the remainder zero. And here after three places, and here how many places are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 places. So actually we have learned about these in the previous classes, the decimals numbers, if it is given, then how to convert into the rational form, means P by Q form, correct? Or simply the fraction form we have learned. Okay, so here 0.5 means what we are doing here, we are writing this after decimal point. So which digits, actual digits are there, means which number it is? 5. So we are writing 5 and taking the denominators as a 1. But the next step is that what is there after decimal point, how many digits is there? 1 digit. So we are putting here 1 0, that everyone know that, correct na? So here this is the 5 by 10. So this 5 by 10 is actual what? The rational number, rational form of this 0.5. Okay, also we can reduce it, right? So here 5 1s are 5 and 5 2s are 10. So you will get 1 by 2, right? So when you will express this number into that 5 by 10, you will get the value 0.5. And also if you reduce this again, then you will get 1 by 2. Then if you will carry out the division like this here, 1 divided by 2, right? So is it possible that in the table of 2 that 1 will come? No. So we are carrying this division 2 0 0, then you will get 1. Again this same happens. So what we are giving here, we are keeping the 0 by your own, right? And for this 0 we are giving a decimal point. So 2 5s are 10. Okay, so 0 0 means here remainder came 0, means here division is stopped. So such a numbers are called which type of number? Terminating decimal numbers. Or the 1.1/2 has the which type of decimal expansion? Terminating decimal expansion. Okay, so here we are going to now express the following numbers into the p/2 form means 0.5 is your decimal form. Which type of decimal expansion for this? Terminating decimal expansion. And this number we can write into the form of p/2 means 5/10. And if you further reduce this, then you will get 1/2. So this is 1/2 is the p/2 form of 0.5. Understood? 1/2 is the p/2 form, means rational number form. p/2, where 2 is what? 2 and p is what? 1. So this is the 1/2 is the rational number form of which number? 0.5. Understood? Now we will see the next example, 0.25. So as usual, you have to write this 25, this number, and divided by 1. Take the denominator as 1. But after decimal point, how many digits are there? 2 digits are there. So how many zeros will come? 2 zeros will come. So we have learned this. Correct? So here. Okay. Now this 25/100 is the number. So which type of number it is? Rational number form. So p/2 form. Okay. So this p/2 form is of which number? Decimal number 0.25. Also we can further divide with this number. So in which number that 2500 becomes? In the table of 25 only. So 25 ones are 25, 25, 4s are 100. So this is 1/4. This is the reduced form of this 25/100, right? So what is the decimal number? 0.25. Then how we can convert into the p/2 form? 1/4. Either this form 25/100, it's of course correct, but we can reduce it, so you will get 1/4. So when you will carry out such a division, you will get 0.25. Right? So this is the decimal number we can express in which form? p/2 form, that is 1/4. Understood everyone? Now next example, 0.675. So this 675, we have to write it as it is. Afterward, this 1 we have to take as the denominator. After decimal point, how many digits are there? 1, 2, 3. So your zeros will come 1, 2, 3. Correct? These both the numbers are the multiples of 5. So we will carry out with the 5. 5 ones are 5. 1 remaining. Then how many here? 17. So 5, 3 are 50. 2 remaining. Then you got here 25. So here 5, 5 are 25. Right? Then 5 is 10. 5, 0, 0. 5, 0, 0. Again these numbers we can 135 divided by 200. These both the numbers are also multiples of 5. Okay. So here, direct 5, 2 are 10. How many remaining here? 30 minus 10, 3. Then 5, 7 are 35. Okay. Then 5, 4 are 20 and 5, 0, 0. So you will get 27/14, correct? So what is the p/2 form of 0.675? That is the 27/14. Okay, now next example. Here we will write this into the fraction form, that is rational number form. 26/5. Here how many after decimal point zeros? 1. How many places are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Correct? Now we have to reduce it. Right? So here 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6, 2 5 are 10, 2 0 0, 0 0 and 0. So you will get your 30 by 50,000. Okay. So this is the rational number form, that is the p by q form of which number? 0.00026. Understood everyone? So now this the numbers of which type? Terminating decimal number. That terminating decimal number we have converted directly into which form? P by Q form, that is the rational number form. Okay. Okay. Next is decimal numbers is of non-terminating nature. So non-terminating means what? The division never stop. Correct. And which type of these numbers are? From this number we can understand this number which type of non-terminating. Repeating bar means after decimal point that particular number groups of digit, if it is bar is there means that particular group is repeated, right? So here one is repeated after decimal point, one is repeated but division never stop, means you will not get the zero. Understood? As a reminder, here after decimal point one place is there means one digit is there, that is which one digit? That 2. That after decimal point one digit, that is 2 bar means 2 will come continuously, right? Here 0.7. okay, so here we got the group of the numbers contain only one digit. Here also one digit, here also one digit, and here also one digit. Then how we can convert this number into which form? P by Q form. Okay, so here first we have to take this 0.1 as a x, right? So let we will take this x equals to 0.1 bar, right? So mean that is x equals to 0.111, that repeated, correct? So after decimal point here a particular group of digit, that particular group of digit, the digit contains only one. How many digits are here? Only one, and that number is repeated. So the numbers or the digits that repeated, that we have to take the before decimal point. Okay, so by which number if you will multiply to these, then you will get this one is before decimal point. How many, which number we have to multiply with this? Yes, we have to multiply with 10, because after decimal point, that is one and only one number. Okay. So that is repeated. So if after decimal point is one number only or one digit is there, then we have to multiply with 10. Okay. One digit is there, 10. Then if supposed to be after decimal point 15, that group of digit contains how many? This group contains how many digits are there? 2 digits are there, right? So means 15 15 15 15 will continuously come, 6 never stop, right? So this group contains how many digits are there? 2 digits. So this number if we have to take before the decimal point, then we have to multiply with 100, correct? If supposed to be 0.925 is there, suppose. Then how many digits contain this repeated group? 1 2 3. So 925 925 925, so on these digits will come. So if you have to take this whole number 3 9 2 5 before decimal point, then we have to multiply with 1000. Okay, so that we have to keep in mind. Okay, now here we will see this first example to convert into the decimal number form. So here by which number we have to take? Multiply with 10. So if you are multiplying here by 10, then here also you have to multiply with 10. Okay. So this is your first statement, right? And this is 0.111 multiply by 10, right? Then you will get here 10x equals to, here this decimal point will means this number will come before decimal point. So 0 1, so 0 1 means what? Your 1 only. So here 1.1 repeated number again you have to write 1, 2, 3 dot dot like this. So this is your second statement. Okay. So afterwards what we have to do? We have to subtract the first from second. Okay. We have to subtract this first from second. So here 10x minus x equals to 1.111 dot 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 minus 0.111. Okay. So here 10x minus x it is 9x equals to here 1 minus 0. Before decimal point which type of number? 1 number. So 1 minus 0 that is 1. And here point after decimal point which numbers are there? 111 and 111. That you will get subtract, right? So 111 and this 111 get 0. So here 0.00 and here 1 minus 0 that is 1. So 1.00 means what? 1. So x means what? X equals to 1 by this 9. So this is 1 by 9. It is the actual what? P by 2 form of your 0.1 bar. Okay. Now next example is 0.2 bar. 2 bar means 2 is repeated number, right? Here division never stops. So here we will take x equals to, let x equals to 0.2 bar, right? So 0.2 bar means that is x equals to 0.222 means that repeat will be there, right? So this we can take as a statement first, right? Now afterwards by which number we have to multiply? 10, 100 or 1000? Yes, of course we have to multiply with 10 because after decimal point that particular number which one? 2. That is the one number only and that is repeated. So when group of number that is in that group contains only the number 1 that repeated, then we have to multiply with 2. Okay. So sorry, then we have to multiply with 10, right? So 10 multiplied by x equals to 0.222 bar multiplied by 10, right? Now here 10 multiplied by x, 10x, and here this decimal point will shift to here, means this 2 will come before decimal point. 02, 02 means only 2. So 2.222, this second statement we will get. Okay. Now we have to do the subtraction between the first and second. So subtract first from second. So here 10x minus x equals to 2.222 minus 0.222. Okay. So here 10x minus x, 9x. After decimal point, whichever the numbers are there are the same. So that will be subtracted. So you will get the 0 for the same. So after decimal point, you will get 0, right? And 2 minus 0, these are the whole numbers. So 2 minus 0, that you got 0, right? So here, x equals to here 2 by 9. So 2 by 9 is the p by 2 form of 0.2 bar. Okay. Now next example, 0.7 bar, right? So 0.7 bar, as usual, we will take x equals to, let x equals to 0.7 bar, right? So which number is repeated here? 7, right? So how many digits are there? Only 1. Okay. So now x equals to 0.777, that is repeated number that we can take as a statement first, right? Then by which number we have to multiply? Here we have to multiply with 10, right? So 10x equals to 0.777 dot 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 multiplied by 10. So you will get 10x equals to, now this decimal point will shift to here. So you will get 7.777, right? And then this is your second statement. Then you have to subtract first from second.
So 10x minus x equals to 7.777 dot dot minus 0.777. Okay, after decimal point, whatever the digits are repeated, that will get 0 after subtracting, right? So x equals to 7/9. So you will get 7/9 is the rational number form, that is the p by q form of this number 0.71. So from this number, what we have observed here, if you will see, then 1/9 of the decimal expansion which number? Means rational form of which number? 0.1/9. Okay, 2/9. So what is the decimal expansion of this? 0.2/9. Right? So 7/9 is the p by q form of which decimal expansion? 0.7/9. Right? So here we can get the idea, if after decimal point there 0.1 particular number of group is comes 0.7 or supposed to be, now it is 0.9. So directly, if it is in the MCQs part, then if we have to find out these objectives are given, and we have to find identify the p by q form of such a number. So we no need to do these all the steps, right? Then we can write directly what we will write, this which number is repeated after decimal point, that is 9, and here this 9. Okay, next example is 0.35/9, right? So after decimal point, which group of the digits will digit is repeated? 35 means you will get 0.35, so on. Here also division never stop, because which type of this number? Non-terminating repetitive, correct? So here this number of group of number is repeated. Non-terminating means the division never stop. Okay, so let we will take this x equals to 0.35/1. Actually, before that we have seen the examples that after decimal point only one digit was there and bar was there, right? So we got the idea directly how to write into the p by q form. So for that objective it is okay, right? So here also we can do the same. See here 0.31. So which number of group is repeated here? 35. So we will write here 35 divided by here. After how many places? After decimal point, how many digits are there? 2 digits, right? So we have to multiply with 100. So from that 100 minus, we have to do that 100x. We have to d minus x. Okay, so you will get 99. So here means to after decimal point only 2 digits are there, then we have to multiply with, sorry, divide with 99. So we will check now whether it is like this only or no, correct na? Understood? So here this x equals to 0.3/9, so you will write here x equals to 0.353535, like this you will write, correct? So this is your first. Afterwards, after decimal point, which group of digit is repeated? 2 digits, right? How many digits are there? 2 digits. So this 35. So we have to take this 35 before decimal point. 35 before decimal point means, in short, we have to shift this decimal point to here. Correct? So whichever your decimal, whichever your group is repeated means, these digits, how many digits are there? This decimal point we have to shift exactly after that number. Okay. So how many digits are there? 2 digits. So we have to multiply with 10 or 100. Yes, we have to multiply with 100. Correct? So 100 multiplied by x equals to 0.353535 multiplied by 100. So you will get here 100x equals to this decimal point after multiplying with the 100, this decimal point will shift here, right? So 35. Now 0.35 is what only? Simply 35. So we can write 0.35 as a 35. So 35 point here, this 35 repeated number will be right. As it is, right? So this is your second. Now you have to subtract this first statement from this second statement. So 100 x minus x equals to means left to left we have subtract, right to right. So here 35.3535 dot dot minus 0.3535. Okay. Right? Then here 100x minus 6, 99x equals to after decimal point. Here after decimal point how many? This 3535 you will write maybe 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, no problem, right? So you can write at least 2 places, 3 places also there. So here 3535 double rupee is there. So we have written here 3535, right? So if it is not there, no problem. Then this is 35 before decimal point, 35 and this 0. This is a whole number. And after decimal point 3535, that will get subtracted. So you will get 0 only. And 35 minus 0, so that is 35. So x equals to what you got? Here 35/99. Understood? So this is the p by 2 form of your 0.3 bar, right? Is it correct? Yes, of course. Means such a number if we ask directly, then we can directly say that the 35/99, that is the rational form of 0.35. okay. Now here similarly we come what? 585 by, how many digits are there? 3 digits, right? So by 1000 will come or 999 will come? Yes, 999 will come, because from 1000 that 1 will come minus from this side, right? So here let x equals to 0.585. So which group is repeated? That same group is repeated. 5, 5, 5, 8, 5. We will write dot dot. This is your, suppose this is first. Okay, then what, by which number we have to multiply after decimal point? This group is repeated, that how many digits are there in that group? 1, 2, 3. How many digits? 3. So you have to multiply with 1000. Correct? So this 1000 multiplied by x equals to 0.585585 dot 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 multiply with 1000, right? So here you will get 1000x equals to, now this decimal point will shift to here, right? Means this 5 will come before decimal point as a whole number, right? So 585.585 dot dot, correct? So this is your second. Now you have to do the subtraction between the first and second. So 1000x minus x equals to 585.585 dot dot minus 0.585. This you have to do the subtraction, correct? Now after decimal point 5, 5. After decimal point 5, 5, that if you will carry into subtraction, you will get 0. And 585 minus 0. Before decimal point, this is the whole number and this is also whole number 0, right? So 585 minus 0, that is 55 only, correct? 585. And after decimal point 5, 5, 5, 5 will get cancelled, that will get 0. So 0.0 means that is your 585, right? And 1000x minus x, 999x. Okay, now we have to find the value of x. So x equals to 585/999. So like this, many numbers we can convert into the p by 2 form, which are, which type of in the nature? Non-terminating repetitive decimal expansion. Okay, that may be converted into the p by 2 form. So if any numbers are there here, a bar is on, supposed to be 4 digit, 5 digit, then we can directly also convert into this form, right? Now afterwards we will see
the conversion of mixed decimal numbers into the which form? P by Q form. Okay. Now we will see the conversion of mixed recurring number. Okay. Now mixed recurring number means this 23.43 bar, right? Means before decimal points whole number is there, and after their number decimal point whatever we got that repeated number, right? So such numbers are called the mixed recurring number. Okay. So here we have to convert this number into the P by Q form. So there are the two methods. Okay. So I will show you two methods how to convert this type of number into the P by Q form. Okay. So we will take let here x equals to 23.43 bar. Then here, so x equals to what will be the 23.43 43 43 like this dot dot. This is your first statement, right? But here now x is whatever needed for the subtraction, that is going to be changed. Then how it is, let us see. Okay, so before decimal point your whole number is there, and after decimal point your 43 43 43 bar, it is correct. So here see 43 means 43 is repeated, that we have to take before decimal point, right? So by which number you have to multiply to this 43 bar, means actually 43 43 43 here, which number we have to multiply this? If you have to take this 43 before the decimal point, after decimal point, then repeated group contain how many digits are there? Two digits are there, so we have to multiply with 100 on both sides, correct? So here 100 into x equals to 23.43 43 43 43 ... 100, correct everyone? Okay, now see here, this will be the 100x, right? Equals to, now this decimal point to shift here after multiplying with 100. So you will get 23 as it is, and this 43 will come before decimal point, means 43. Now decimal point will be here, right? And this number you have to write as it is, 43 43 ... This is your second statement. Okay, now here we got 100x equals to 23 means 2343.4343 bar. Okay, and here your x is what? 23.43 43 43 ... right? Means that repeated number. So subtraction will be there, 100x minus x equals to this 23 43. What is the value of 100x? This is 23 43, means 2343.4343 ... minus what is the 23.4343 ... Okay, now after decimal point that repeated number get cancelled because we are carrying here what? Subtraction, right? So you will get 0 for the same. Okay, so after decimal point you will get, here after decimal point you will get 0. If you write 2 times 3, then that is 0, right? And 23 is the whole number, that is before decimal point, and here before decimal point 23 is a whole number. So how you will carry out this? 2343, here you will write here 23, or here we will write the 23 because this is the 2-digit number and it is whole. So we have to write here 23, right? So 2343 - 23. Okay, so you will get here 0, 4 minus 2, 2, and this 3 and this 2. So you got here 2320.0. So 0.0 is, there is no need to write this 0.0. Okay, and here 100x minus x, you will get 99x, right? So x equals to 2320 divided by 99.
9. Understood everyone? This is the first method to convert this mixed recurring number into the which form? P by Q form. Okay. Now we will see the another method that is very easy. You can carry any method one of them. Okay. So here, let this your number is what? 23.43. Bar. Okay. Now, how you will write this number? See, 23, this is your whole number, plus 0.43 bar. Okay. After decimal point, what you write this number? 0.43 bar. Okay. Then, this remains as it is. 23 remains as it is. Plus, now we have learned the previous example that suppose 0.7 bar. How you will write 0.7 bar if you want directly into the P by Q form? You will write 7 by what? 9. Right? If 17 means 0.17 bar, then how you will write directly? That we have seen the district to 17 by 99. Right? So similarly, can we write this number here? What will be there? 0.43 bar, you will write 43 upon 99. Means this number, if you can be like this, then you will get 43 by 99. Okay. So here, now everyone know that what to do. Here we have to make the multiplication of this. Correct? So 99 multiplied by 23. Then here we have to make it addition of this. Plus 43 divided by 99. So here you have to carry out the multiplication of these two numbers. And then plus 43. Okay. Now here, after making the multiplication, you will get here 2277 means 2277 plus 43 upon 99. Okay, you have to do the multiplication of this. Then after multiplying this number, you will get here 2277 and this plus 43. Now carry out this addition. 7 plus 3, 10. Give here 7 plus 5, 12. Okay. Then 1 here. Then 2 plus 1, 3 and this 2 and divided by 99. So this is the P by Q form. 2320. Here also we got the same. 2320 divided by 99. Correct? So this is the P by Q form of your mixed recurring number, which 23.43. So here are these two methods. We have to solve such examples by any of the method. Understood?